Hello guys, Engineering Graphics for first year Polytechnic. Today we are going to draw very interesting topic, that is isometric cylinder, the construction of cylinder having isometric projection. I am saying isometric projection, so we have to take the dimension as it is given in the question. So here I have drawn question. So, now in front you can observe there is a rectangle having dimension in the height side, that is 80. You have to read dimension in the front view. There are two dimensions you will get in the front view, that is length and the height. Height is 80 mm. Now in top view you will get another two dimensions, that is, this is the length side again, this is 50 mm because radius is given, that is 25 mm. So you will get the radius plus radius, that is diameter, as equal to length, that is 50 mm. So now this side is the width side on the top side. So this will be again same, 25 plus 25, that is 50. So length of this object is 50, height of this object is 80, and the width of the object is the again 50. So now this is the problem, as this is the circle in the top side. So, as this is the rectangle in the front view, we have to stretch it according to the circle. So, this will become a cylinder. So, that's what we are going to draw here. Now, for that, we have to first set a drafter on one horizontal line here. It should be faint, it should be very faint. Then, a perpendicular line to this, having in the height side, that is 80 mm, so we have to draw 80 mm line here. That is also a faint line. Now, as this is isometric, we have to tilt this object in 30 angle from both the side. So I will set my drafter here, now 30. You can see here, 30. There is 1 degree error in this, so I am taking 31 here, so that it will be 30. Now, suppose this is the length side of the object, so I will take 50 in this side on 30 angle. So this is 50, as you can see here, 50. Now I have tilted drafter upside to take the length side. Now I have to tilt downside again 30. So I will take first, this is the 1 degree error, so I have to take 31 in this side. You can see here, 31. Now again, I have to take 50 mm length on this side. So now these are the three principal lines, what we so called height, length and width. There is a 30 degree angle in between these two lines. Again, 30 degree angle in between two lines. Now I have to make a box. Now I have to make the drafter perpendicular to the height, so I can draw another two lines here, 80 mm 80 mm. So this will be here 80 mm, and again this also 80 mm. Now I have to take the length side parallel and draw two lines, connect these two lines. Now here I will take 50 mm. Yes. Now 1, 2, 3 lines are parallel. 1, 2, 3 lines are parallel. Now I have to go for width side. I have to set my drafter parallel to width side. I have to connect these two points. And I have to connect these two points. Now I got 4 points on the top side. As this circle, this is the top view, you can see here. So this top view will come here. So I have to make isometric circle here. So there is a standard procedure for that. So I will give first names here. This is, for example, A, B, C and D. These are the 4 points. Now you have to look for the longer diagonal. Now AC is the longer diagonal than BD. So AC is the longer. So you have to connect this first, this longer diagonal. I have connected it. Now You have to calculate the center points of this all sides. So BC have the center point at 25 mm. AD also get a center point at 25 mm. Again, this AB will get a center point at 25 mm. Now BC also get a center point at 25 mm. Now I got 4 points, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now I have to connect this 1, 2 from point D. So the shape will look like V from here, and I have to connect from this B, point B to 4 and 3. So it will look like again V, downside V, upside V here. So I'm going to connect B to 4 and B to 3. Now D to 1, 2 will, V will come over there. Now D to 2. So I got another 2 points here. 3 lines are intersecting at a point, that is 5 and 6. These points are very important now. I'll take the compass now. I have to take the center as D and the radius as D to 1. And I have to connect it. One, two, two. 1 to 2, I'm saying. Then I have to keep compass at point B and take 4, 2, 3. 4, 2, 3. Now take center point at 6 and keep at 2 and connect it. Like this, 2 to 3, then keep it at 5, 4 to 1. Now you can see here, observe here, this is the complete one isometric circle in the top side. There's a little mistake coming here, it should not come if you take all lines parallel properly. Now this is the isometric circle at the top, as this is coming here in top view. So now look at the front view, you will get 2 lines like this. These are the 2 lines you can see here. Now you have to take the projection from this point to this point downside. Now make a drafter parallel to vertical line. Come downside as much as you can. Now erase this point. Close it. Okay. I don't need this line now. Now again, if I want to draw another half circle here, another isometric circle here, so again the same procedure will come. So I have point A here, same like point upside. I have point D here, I have point C here. There is one point missing here. So AB is 50 mm, so I will keep parallel to BC and I will draw AB, this length side parallel. Now we have to find out this B point, as this is 50 mm. So I have to take another 50 mm line here. It should be faint, 50 mm. Now I have to join this C to B. No. This is the point B. A, B, C, D again. I have to find out 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 points. Okay, again. So find out the center points here. This is the 2.5, 2.5, 2.5, and 2.5. Again, I will write the same in the same way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, 4 points. Now, I have to find out this 5 and 6. So, I will connect this AC first. And afterwards, I have to go D to 1 and D to 2. Now I have to connect this point D to 1, D to 2. So I'm going to draw fast now. Afterwards I have to connect B to 4 and B to 3. We have to make two V's. This one and this one. These three lines will intersect at two points. This is point number 5 and point number 6. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, from these two projection lines, I got this point P on this diagonal, this point Q, this projection, P and Q. Now, these are important, these are the limit for this half circle I'm going to draw. Now, this inside arc will not be visible from top side. And this outside circle will be visible from front side. So I will draw outside as a dark. From B, I have to keep at 4 till 3. So this one, and I have to keep at 0.5. 4 to P. This is very important now. 4 to P only. And at 6, you have to keep, take at the center and draw this. Three to Q. Four to P and three to Q. Now I have to join, make this line dark. So it will become isometric cylinder. So we were going fast. So it's a little mistake here. So it
now isometric cylinder. This is the construction of isometric cylinder. If you do more practice with the drafter, so there will not be any single error. So thank you very much for watching this. If you observe carefully, you will, it is very easy, but it took very much time to explain here. Thank you very much. Visit again. Thank you.